Hello guys and welcome to a new episode of How to DIY RC to the Eachine E010c version motor and frame upgrade to get a flying proper FPV instead of the 10 seconds as you could have seen in the review. Standard stock, it's not really performing the way we like it. It really needs the motor upgrade and frame to really improve the performance from this little quad. And these motors are from the furibee F36 and giving us 40 grams of thrust, and that is pretty amazing because the normal stock quad without the FPV camera weighs only 20 grams, so that's a 2-to-1 power to weight ratio, making it flying super fast. Then the frame is from the Eachine E010c version. I put all the links down below. The nice thing about this frame is it's almost the same weight, but it's more aerodynamic for the flow of the motors, and it shines through. I don't know if it really shows up on camera, but if the lights turn on of the quad, it really lights up the whole quad and makes it fly like a UFO. It's really, 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 really nice. I'm liking it. But let's get back to the upgrade that we are going to fix. And it's going to be pretty simple. We're just going to have to remove the canopy and battery. What I meant to say is the flight board. And just desolder the motors and put this flight board and then add the camera later on straight into this frame. And then we have to make sure that you have put the props on the correct way. This motor should turn clockwise. This motor should turn counterclockwise. This motor should turn clockwise. And this one should turn... Oh, this one should turn clockwise. And this one should turn counterclockwise. So if you have that correct, and if it doesn't correct, then just change out the two wires on the circuit board to make it correct. And let's go in and desolder them and change it up. And there's only one good way it fits. The battery connector in the big hole, that's the rear. We've soldered all the wires to the correct color scheme. It looks like we put the black wire to the negative and the red wires to the positive. And let's hope we did it correct. Everything is backwards. It's pushing down to the ground instead of going up. Oh, let's do that again. This time we changed everything around and just put the red wire to the minus and the black wire to the positive. And let's test again. Perfect. That's what we wanted. That's what we needed. Now we're gonna hook up the FPV and fly outside and test. But before the test flight, I always want to check the weight. And this is with battery, camera, and the canopy. And it's 25.7. Wow. Wow, that's heavy. But I know I got 40 grams of thrust, so it should really fly really good. Let's go outside and have a go. And I'm finally the test flight. I'm checking if we can carry the weight of the FPV and the canopy. And if this is really a proper upgrade, yes or no. Well, it's flying a lot longer than 10 seconds already, and I got full control, and it stays off the ground. It is pretty good, so pretty good, pretty nice. Only the stock transmitter doesn't have that much angle, not even on high rates. I want to have more angle because I'm used to having the multi-particle TX module. But that was the landing, and still it can fly a lot longer. The battery is still okay. I'm just gonna cut the video over here. I want to say this is the proper upgrade that you really need for the Eachine E010c version to get a very flying proper FPV. And this, the links will be finding down below. I hope you give this video a like and subscribe. And for the next video where we're going maybe through the upgrade for a range, I want to say goodbye. Until next time.